My name is Mike Byster, and my superhuman ability is mental math.
In a moment, you'll use your math skills to figure out the sticker price of each car.
Are you ready to continue?
I think so.
All right, Mike, keep your brain going for the last sales pitch.
My friend, you look like a smart fellow, so there's only one ride you need. It's the 1983 conversion van. It has it all: power windows, power brakes, power locks, power seats, and power steering. And this automobile is a literal steal at just $320 a month for 60 months. Of course, that's just the base model. This little beauty is a little extra. Add on $220 for the windows, $550 for the power brakes, $80 for the power locks, $195 for the power seats, $625 for the Mad Dog security system, $30 a month for 5 years for satellite radio. Actually, I'll throw the radios first month in free, and the power steering, I'll throw that in for free too, except a fee of $210. But hold on, you are a safe driver, so we'll knock $10 off of all 60 monthly payments, and on top of that, your trade-in equals $820 off the total too. But before we go any further, you'll also need a warranty, just $45 a month over the course of the 60-month lease. Then there's all that legal mumbo-jumbo, so you've got to add taxes, title, and rebate, which puts us very tiny $2,830 on the bill. And heck, I like you, so I'm willing to take a flat 10% off the top of this bad boy. What do you say? Can I get you in this car today?
Before the discount is $26,960. With the discount, we're looking at $24,264.
Yeah!
Hi, my name is Mike Byster, and I have one of the fastest mathematical minds in the world. To give you an example of what my mind could do, my son and I practice sometimes. We do something called the 90-second challenge, where he reads me a bunch of math problems, and I also do a trick where he takes a deck of cards and he pulls one out, and I look through the deck and tells what's missing, and I also do something where I could take a word of any length and spell it in alphabetical order. We do a bunch of these in 90 seconds. Here's a clip of it.
758.
574564.
4963.
Backwards, 9631 3642. 3 digit divided by 2 digit.
825.23.
That equals 35.869 565217391. We got 22 digit numbers.
57, 46, 28, 75, 93, 44, 67, 85, 27, 93, 26, 87, 35, 52, 76, 84, 69, 38, 58, 86.
1226. Now we have a 10-letter word in alphabetical order.
Understand.
ADDENNRSTU. Now we have the deck of cards. Okay, hold on, real quick. Jack Arts. Okay, now we have 10 dates in history. Go.
February 19th, 1933.
Sunday.
July 24th, 2052.
Wednesday.
May 6th, 1854.
Saturday.
January 15th, 2010.
Friday.
August 9th, 1966.
Tuesday.
October 16th, 2020.
Friday.
June 8th, 1908.
Monday.
August 22nd, 1875.
Sunday.
December 21st, 2097.
Saturday.
September 19th, 1985.
Thursday, stop the clock. Woo! High five. Good job, Dodger.
What I really like doing is teaching kids how to improve their minds. And I try to do it in fun ways. So I'm gonna teach you a couple card tricks, but they're not magic tricks. There's a math trick and there's a memory trick. The first is a math trick, and it has to do with adding up to 10, two numbers that add up to 10. The combinations of two numbers that add up to 10 are, with cards, an ace, which is considered 1, and 9. A 2 and an 8 add up to 10. A 3 and a 7 add up to 10. A 4 and a 6 add up to 10. And a 5 and a 5 add up to 10. And also, 10s alone are already adding up to 10. My son Josh is filming this to pick two cards, and if they add up to 10, the trick won't work. But almost all the times, the cards don't add up to 10, so usually the trick will work the first time through. So Josh will pick two cards and see if they don't add up to 10. Don't worry about picture cards. Are we good?
Yep.
Okay, now I'm gonna make 10 piles. Now, you have to look for combinations that add up to 10. 9 and ace, a 9, ace is considered 1, that adds up to 10. So I put a card on the 9 and a card on the ace. 5 and 5 add up to 10. So I put a card on the 5 and a card on the other 5. How about 7 and 3? They add up to 10 too. 7 and 3. 4 and 6 add up to 10. 4 and 6. Now for this trick, Jack, Queen, King are usually not numbers, but for this trick, we consider Jack, Queen, King adding up to 10. So if there's a Jack, Queen, King, they all have to be out at the same time. You could cover them all. Jack, Queen, King. 9 and 8 add up to 10. Jack, Queen, King adds up to 10. Jack, Queen, King. 4 and 6 add up to 10. Now, there is no combination that adds up to 10 that I can see. The trick's not over. We just have to add a new pile. And another new pile. And another new pile. Jack, Queen, King. 7 and 3 add up to 10. 10 is 10. 8 and 2 are 10. 10 is 10. 3 and 7 add up to 10. 5 and 5 add up to 10. 6 and 4 add up to 10. Jack, Queen, King all adds up to 10. Jack, Queen, King. And I have one card left. And usually you cannot cover half a pile. So I couldn't cover like 9 and 9 and 8. But there's a 10, I would just make a new pile. But because there's a 10 showing, you cover a 10 alone, I could cover the 10. Now I'm gonna pick them up in groups of 10. 9 and 8 add up to 10. 4 and 6 add up to 10. 10 adds up to 10. 2 and 8 adds up to 10. 2 and 8 adds up to 10. 1 more 2 and 1 more 8 add up to 10. Now we have these left. Now what would make this pile 10? We have a 9, 8 would make this pile 10. What would make this pile 10? A 7. Josh, are your two cards an 8 and a 7? Perfect. More perfect, that's great. Okay, that's how the trick works. This is a memory trick, and it's a really simple trick, but it's amazing, and all you have to do is memorize the steps. Okay, you have a full deck of cards, you flip over a card, and whatever that card is, you count up to the number 13 from that number. So 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And we do it 4 times. If you ever throw over a card, and the first card of any new pile is a picture card, you put it back in the deck. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. We do it 4 times. Ace is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. That is step 1. Step 2, we're going to flip the cards face down. Step 3, you are going to pick one, or you're going to have someone else pick one pile, and we're going to put it back in the deck. So 1, 2, 3, 4, I'm going to pick 3 and put it back in the deck. It doesn't matter what number it is. Just have someone else pick a pile and put it back in the deck. It doesn't matter if you put it on the top or the bottom. Step 4 is the step that most people forget because it doesn't involve cards. You tell whoever you're doing the trick to, and it could be a group of people, everyone put the number 10 in your head. And everyone puts the number 10 in their head. Step 5, I'm going to have Josh give me 2 numbers, pile 1, pile 2, pile 3, and we're going to flip over the top card, and whatever they are, we're going to add it to the 10 that's in your head. Josh, 2 numbers, 1, 2, and 3.
How about 1 and 2?
1 and 2. Everyone have 10 in their head? 10 plus 8 is 18, plus 3 is 21. That's our special number. I'm gonna count out 21 cards from my hand. When I'm done counting out 21 cards, however cards are left in my hand will always, always equal the top card of the unturned over pile. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. How many cards do I have left over? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This has to be a 7. And it works every time. Now, I am really big on something called mnemonic devices, ways to help people remember. And the way I tell people to remember the steps is think of the sentence, 13 minus 1 equals 10 plus 2. 4 piles up to 13. flip them over, take away one pile, put the number 10 in your head, and then flip over the top card of two different piles. 13 minus 1 equals 10 plus 2. I hope you enjoyed learning. I enjoyed helping you learn. Have a great day.